Alright, it's been a while since I took a look at a shooter, and a Neo Geo game at that, so let's do 2-on-1. I did a video on the first game in the series, so I might as well do it on the second one as well. This is Aero Fighters 2, also known as Sonic Wings 2, in Japan. It was developed by Video System, published by SNK in 1994. Came out for the arcade Neo Geo, the home Neo Geo, that is the AES, as well as the Neo Geo CD, all three of them. And it's not really that much different from the first one, it's just more of the same. Which is fine, it's a difficult shooter, challenging, just like the first one. Not very long, as most shooters aren't. And it's got really great music, it's just a lot of fun to play. Of course, it's all about score and gameplay in this, but there is a little bit of a kind of a story, but it's not much there, just like in the first one. It's more goofy, though, slightly, than the first one, so I guess that's, you know, give it points for that. But the more interesting thing about this is, if you're playing two-player mode, depending on what characters you choose, the ending is actually different, and depending on what combination, you can get different endings, so there's, again, reason to replay it for that, too. So, yeah, I'm only playing solo, of course, here. Anyway, for kicks, and just like I've been doing for shooters, anytime I do videos on those for the longest time now, I only use one credit, but I might use another one because I'm not a master at this game. We'll see. See how it goes first. Anyway, so there's Robo Keaton's jet. Yes, Robo Keaton, the F-117 Nighthawk, which is a plane I like a lot and I usually use in this. But I'm not going to be using something different this time. He's got some funny lines, though. The translation, or the English, is kind of all over the place. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's not. So as you see, the US has got two jets, Japan's got two jets, Europe's got two jets, but France and Great Britain only get one each, the long bounce. Like I said, I usually use Rebel Keaton there, but I like the F-15 here a lot, so I'm going to go with her, Mao Mao. Each jet has its own kind of uniqueness to it in terms of what the bomb pattern is and the regular firing when you upgrade it, but also some are slightly stronger than others. Also, something else that's different is, this first stage is always the same, but depending on who you choose, you'll go to another stage different, so I'll be going to New York after this one, usually. A little bit of variation there too, so it keeps things from getting boring. Of course, you stick with whatever plane is your favorite. Like I said, it's not a very long game, but it is a decently challenging shooter. It's not unfair, though. Again, I can keep saying all day, it's pretty much just like the first one, only more. However, there's a couple things. There is some slowdown in this, not often. It is there. It's not that noticeable. It doesn't really cause any problems, so, whatever. I always wonder why that guy never gives you anything. It's not hard to take out, but whatever. Anyway, so here's the first boss. He's not that bad, even I'll say that, not being great at this game. Just blow his bits off and you'll fine. All you gotta really worry about is his small bullets, which, it could be just me, but a lot of times in games like this, I have such a hard time trying to see those. Fortunately, you can destroy his bigger shots. It's one of those kind of shooters. Not always, though. So you gotta watch out for that. And there you go. Did that without using any bombs, which is what I wanted to do. That was so bad after all. Don't brag, it's only gonna make it more brutal. This is on level 4, as you can see at the bottom there. That's the default, by the way. I never change it. Why? Keep it what it is supposed to be. Alright, so here we are in the night stage. I like this level. More difficult than the first one, as you might imagine, but it's cooler. Get the radar planes here. Now, this came out in 1994, so it was a different time back then, and you're going to see something soon, probably. You're probably not going to find tasteful. It's just the way it is. That's all I'm going to say. No other comments. You'll know it when you see it. Actually, I'm in Paris. Never mind. We're not going to see the thing I was talking about yet. If I live long enough, you will. This is all for fun. Just showing off the game. This... helicopters are kind of hard to take out. They take a lot of hits. Oh, I went right into him. Anyway, gives me time to talk about this. You really don't want to die in this because if you do die, you lose whatever weapon upgrades you have, so... unfortunately, I did. I wasn't trying to die there. I've done better. Alright, I gotta get that. There you go. Come on. Oh, that'll help. Alright. Try and do this without dying again, but I don't know. There you go. It's kind of like a Konami enemy. They flash red when they're about to die. I have no bombs. But I killed him at least. I actually lived through that one. Oh. I went right into that guy's shot too and lost a life. I wasn't trying to do that, by the way.
Yes.
And this is the thing it was showing in the demo. Or a different variation on it.
Yes, keep collecting those. If not just for points. I want my extra life.
This is a great way to rack up score. Assuming you get a little bit more than I did right there. But still, that's not bad. I have to go on. I can't quit now. See, her lines are kind of good. As far as the translation goes, at least it makes sense what she's saying. It's not funny like Robo Keaton. He's the comedy character, I think.
Oh, that was close.
Look, I'm not trying to get close calls. It just happens. I am starting to get kind of tired, though. Oh, there it is. I gotta really watch where I'm moving. Get the letters for points. Onward for great justice and pancakes. I don't know. Oh, ho ho ho. Oh man, not good. Give me that. Oh. See, the unique thing about the bomb in this, at least with this plane, is it kind of freezes enemies and you still shoot them. It doesn't specifically kill them. Again, that's the thing where each jet has its own strengths and weaknesses and uniqueness to it. I have no bombs, though. Just want to say that. I'm all on my own. It doesn't bode well for me, personally. Oh. Yeah, I did that to myself. You have no idea how fast I'm mashing that button. Woohoo! Oh, I didn't see that. At least it's almost dead. Part of the problem is getting tired. I'm good at button mashing, but even I have a limit. many of you have seen me do many videos with this with button mashing, and I don't complain about it, but some games just wear me down, like this one. Alright, so here's New York. Now, assuming I live long enough, you're going to see the kind of, you could deem, tasteless thing. Some of you might know what I'm referring to. Yeah, I'm going to go a little bit longer. Why not? That was a waste of a bomb. No comment. It was 1994. Different times, man, different times. And more radar planes. Oh, I didn't even see that one. This really starts ramping up. And unfortunately, you don't really get that long of a kind of button mashing break, sadly. Alright, I kind of wasted that so I can get those safely. If only your weapon stayed that powerful all the time when you get the fangs, but it just doesn't. Still, for that first credit, I did alright. Alright, so here's a much more difficult boss. Oh man, oh shh. I'm not kidding, this is hard. Oh. Anyway, I'm just going to give you my final conclusion on this one right now. I highly recommend it, if you can't tell. I really like this one. Yes, it is kind of an endurance test in some ways, but it's a lot of fun. It really is a good shooter, and if you like the first one a lot, definitely look into this. Oh, I wasn't trying to do that. But anyway, yeah, if you like the first one, definitely look into this one as well. It's a very fun shooter. It's challenging, without a doubt, but it's not unfair. Anyway, so that's it. Thank you for watching, and I will see you later.